show alone. They turn down the lights and turn the projector on. And just as the news of the world started to begin, I saw my darling and my best friend walk in. Though I was sitting there, so they sat right down in front of me. When he kissed her lips, I almost died. And in the middle of the color cartoon, I started to cry.
What was all that about?
I didn't do it. Nobody saw me do it. You can't prove anything.
Little baby gun.
Where's your papa gun?
Yes, Sarge. I'd rather be listening to Veterans Radio Net.
Veterans Radio Net. Your music, your station.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. You're tuned in with Sapper Ken here on VRN on the... good evening, Mr. Miller. How are you doing, sir? Nice to have your company. Got a bunch of old sappers down in Paynton in Devon tuned in as well. Mel, Michael, and Robert, snoring for England. Robert, wake up. You'll... wake up. If you don't wake up now, you're going to wake up in the morning with something shaved off. And if Mel's had too much of that port and cheap red Argentinian wine, I'm not sure what it is that's going to be shaved off. But there you go. You're tuned in to Sapper Ken here on Veterans Radio Net. And in about 35 minutes, we will be going live on air to the streets of Chester in Lancashire. And we'll be talking with Les Standish. Les is X2 para. He's a Northern Ireland and Falklands War veteran. He's also the recipient of the Military Medal for his actions during the Battle of Goose Green in 1982. Les is sleeping rough on the streets of Leicester for a week. Over bonfire night, brave man. This is to highlight the plight of some of our brothers and sisters who can only sleep on the street because they've got nowhere else. And also to highlight the absolute fantastic work done by the charity Soldiers Off the Street. So, as I say, that will be in about 35 minutes. Hi, Dusty. Hi, all. Okay, have you any rain? I did not. Oh, I take it that's Laz. Good evening, Lawrence. How are you doing, sir? Dusty say, now saying he's got lots of rain here in Northamptonshire. It's actually turning out to be a reasonably bright evening. We've had a lot of rain during the day, but the sun is shining at the moment. There is some cloud up there. It's breezy. It's not as warm as it was, but it is, what, the 2nd of November, so there you go. Don't apologise, Lawrence. We'll get there. We'll work it out. Spreaker does what it wants to do to us, doesn't it? Right, I'm going to play you a little bit of Christopher and Borderlines. I'll be back shortly, guys. Chatboard is open. Please feel free to use it.
Standing in the station, I am waiting for a train to take me to the border and my loved one far away. I watched a bunch of soldiers heading for the war. I could hardly even bear to see them go. Rolling through the countryside, tears are in my eyes. We're coming to the borderline. I'm ready with my lies. And in the early morning rain, I see her there. And I know I'll have to say goodbye again.
Breaking my heart, I know what I must do.
past the border guards, reaching for her hand, showing no emotion. I wanna break into a run, but these are only boys, and I will never know how men can see the wisdom in a war.
Horror.